Inflation is a term commonly used by economists and non-economists alike. But what really is inflation, and how do we measure it? Inflation is an increase in the price level of an economy. Basically, how does the cost of buying goods and services change over time? To help us understand inflation, let's look at the most common way to calculate it, the Consumer Price Index, or CPI. The CPI is a theoretical basket of consumer goods. This basket is supposed to contain items that an average person buys regularly, such as food, household supplies, or heating bills. It aims to reflect the average cost of living in any given place. Once this list has been assembled, economists can measure the price of everything in the basket to track how prices have changed over time. More information on different ways to measure inflation, such as the GDP deflator, can be found from the description of this video. Now we know how to measure it, we can ask, why does inflation occur? There are three main causes. The first economists call demand pull inflation. This occurs when demand outpaces supply. When people want more of something than there is an increase in supply, prices will rise. Anything that causes an increase in aggregate demand, such as economic growth, can cause demand pull inflation. The second cause of inflation is called cost push inflation. Generally, cost push inflation is when aggregate supply falls. When the cost of production rises and supply falls, producers also raise their prices in order to remain profitable. These falls in supply can be caused by supply chain disruption, often associated with war or environmental factors such as droughts or floods. Rising oil and gas prices are a common aggregate supply shock that can cause inflation. The third cause of inflation is monetary inflation. This is when increases in the money supply can cause a price increase, even if the underlying economic activity hasn't changed. Since more money is now chasing after the same amount of economic output, prices increase. Monetary inflation can be caused by governments printing too much money or the central bank decreasing the interest rate too far. Overall, inflation can be a good or a bad thing depending on the economic context. Capitalist systems require a degree of inflation in order to remain viable. Historically, most modern developed economies have aimed for a stable inflation rate of around 2% per year. This has been considered a sign of a healthy growing economy. It is difficult to know whether inflation is a good or bad thing without knowing more about the state of the economy. However, when inflation reaches extremely high levels, it is clearly undesirable. We have a special word for this situation, hyperinflation. When monthly inflation is more than 50%, we call it hyperinflation. Hyperinflation is usually caused by governments printing excess money, often during times of war or severe economic turmoil. In this situation, the government keeps printing more and more money to finance its debts. But the ever-increasing amount of money being printed drastically changes the amount of money in the economy overall, so prices rise rapidly. Suddenly, people's savings aren't worth as much anymore, and old coins and bills can become basically worthless overnight. Hyperinflation can be solved by a few different strategies, including reissuing and redefining the currency, or even adopting a different currency instead. For more information about inflation and hyperinflation, and ways to measure them, head over to the economics terms A to Z on INOMICS.com. And if you liked this video and want more, be sure to subscribe to our channel. Bye!